Hello dear students, today we are going to study a 10th standard poem which is written by Basavanna and it is translated in English by A.K. Ramanujan and it is also called Vachana. This poem is also called Vachana. Another name for this poem is Vachana. Actually these are the Vachanas which were written by Basavanna and these are written in Kannada language. So it is translated in English by A.K. Ramanujan. Let's see what the poem is. So what the poem is telling, the first stanza of the poem, what the poem is appealing, that requesting to the God. What it is telling, see here. The rich will make temples for Shiva. What the first line is telling, the rich people can afford to construct a temple for Shiva. The rich people, those who are having the money, they can construct the temple, like the buildings for temple they will construct. But what he is telling, make temples for Shiva, what shall I, a poor man? He is telling that himself, he is telling that I am a poor man. What shall I do? What shall I, a poor man, do? He is requesting, he is asking to the God. He is asking the God, what shall I do? I am a poor man. I can't construct that temple for you. What can I do? What can I do? He is asking to the God. In this first stanza, it is very easy poem. Let's see what the question will be asked to your examination. What does the rich will make temple for Shiva imply? What it implies? It implies that the rich people can afford to construct a temple, to construct a building for temple. They can afford, but the poor can't afford that. That it is telling. What shall I, a poor man, do? Mean what it means? It means that it is not possible. He can't afford to construct such temples like the rich people construct. And in this question, this type of question will be asked in extract also. They will give only one single line. What shall I, a poor man, do? So we have to write the extract. Like this sentence is taken from the poem, The Temple and the Body, which is written by Basavanna. We have to write, and after that, so we have to write that when he, it was said when he was asking to God, what shall I do? As the rich people are constructing the temples for you, but I am a poor man. How can I construct a temple? I can't afford a temple for you. What shall I do? He is requesting to the God. That we have to write the reference to the context. If he asks you in the reference to the context, like he will give only one single sentence, that you have to write the complete reference when it was said. The second stanza of the poem, what the second stanza is telling, he is comparing the body to the temple in the second stanza. How he is comparing, let's see. My legs are pillars. He is comparing, as the temple stands on the pillars, so my body is standing. How the body is standing on the legs? So he is comparing to the pillars, to the legs. Legs are like pillars. How the temples are having the pillars in the temple, the same way my body is also a shrine. My body is a shrine and my legs are the pillars. He is telling, my legs are pillars. Pillars of the temple. The body, the shrine. The body jo hai, wo shrine hai. The center mein jaise shrine hota hai, like एक स्टैचू होता है टेम्पल के अंदर, द श्राइन इज कॉल्ड. सो द सेम वे द बॉडी द श्राइन, बॉडी जो है मेरा वो श्राइन है. एंड द हेड अ कपोल ऑफ गोल्ड, एंड ही इज कंपेयरिंग द हेड टू द कपोल ऑफ गोल्ड. एज द टेम्पल इज हैविंग द कपोल ऑफ गोल्ड विच इज हैविंग लाइक दिस टाइप ऑफ शेप. So he is comparing to the head as it is the top part. As the temples are having the top part, the same way my head is also like cupola of gold. So in this manner, he is comparing his body to the temple. Let's see what the question will be asked to you in the examination. How is the human body compared to the temple? So we have to write the same lines, like he compared the body to the temples, like legs are compared with the pillars, body is compared to the shrine, and head is compared to the cupola of gold. In this manner you have to write. Next, what is the message of the poem? What the message we are getting from this poem? Like the message what we are getting is, The human body is temporary, it can die, but the soul, where the God exists, that never, it is, it never be possible to destroy it. So what he is requesting is the God to stay in the soul, in the body there is a soul, in that soul he wants the God to stay. Next question, how can our body be likened to a temple? The same answer we will get here again. So the body is compared, like the legs are compared to the pillars, and the body is compared to the shrine, and the head is compared to the cupola of gold. How is the human head a cupola? How the human head is a cupola? Like the temples are having the cupola, the same manner the head is the top part, and it is compared to the cupola of gold. Now in the last stanza of the poem, what the Baswana is conveying, let's see. Listen, O Lord of meeting rivers. Now what he is asking? He is asking the Lord to listen. What he is saying? Listen, O Lord of meeting rivers. To whom he is saying, Lord of meeting rivers? To Shiva. What he is telling to the Shiva? Listen, he is telling to listen. Think standing shall fall. So what he is telling, things standing shall fall. So here, the standing refers to the temple. Temple shall fall. जो temple खड़ा हुआ है, वो क्या हो जाएगा? One day it will fall. वो क्या हो जाएगा? एक दिन गिर जाएगा. So here one more poetic device is also used. That paradox is also used. Paradox. What the meaning of paradox? Paradox is nothing but here the two opposite ideas are used. Like standing is also there, fall is also there. The two opposite ideas are there in the same sentence, and it is called paradox. So here paradox is used. But the moving ever shall stay. And what he is saying? Moving ever shall stay. Moving is nothing but here soul. The soul of the human beings transfer from one body to another body. This is the belief of the Hinduism. So what he is telling, that the soul will move from one body to another body, and it is not having any death. So he is requesting the God or requesting the Shiva to stay in the soul. So what the word is here? But the moving refers to the soul. What is referred? Soul. He is referring to the soul. Ever shall stay. That it will never stay on our place. Who will not stay on our place? That soul will not stay on our place. So that's why he is requesting the Shiva to stay in his soul. Let's see what the question will be asked to you in the examination. What the message these above lines convey? What the message above lines are conveying? The above lines are conveying a message that the temples which are constructed, they are materialistic and they will destroy one or another day. But the soul and the belief in the God, it will never destroy. So that's why he is requesting the God to stay in the soul. And the next question, what final message do the last two lines convey? The same message what I have said to the above answer, the same answer will come to that. What opposite ideas are suggested in the moving shall ever stay? What the opposite ideas? See, moving shall ever stay. What it means? That जो चीज मूव होती है वो कभी रुकती नहीं, वो बता रहा है. सो दैट इज विच इज इट इज कम्पेयर टू द सोल. सोल विच इज मूविंग फ्रॉम वन बॉडी टू अनदर बॉडी, इट विल नेवर स्टे इन आवर प्लेस. So this is the poem which is written by Baswana, the temple and the body. I hope that you have understood the poem, and the final message of the poem is that he is requesting to the God to stay in the human body, in the human soul, that the things which are materialistic like temple and this body which is present here, that it is going to be destroyed one or another day. But the soul will never destroy, and it is the belief of Baswana that he is requesting the Shiva to stay in the